fact is, we're finding that it's easier and faster than ever before to receive information, to download apps, to get an easier user experience via mobile. And we're on our phones, right? So we're out there and we're now doing things. And if you're not, I promise it's okay that you don't have to be, but I promise your consumers, your customers, your buyers, your sellers, whatever business you're in, your folks, your audience are using their mobile device. So in all new ways, there are examples that we can use. And today we're going to talk about mobile listings. That's the way to market a product or market a service or market your name or your organization or your fundraising drive, any of those things with a keyword tied to a short code. Yeah, those will make sense when we're done, I promise. And the second is mobile alerts. Basically, as we've always had email subscribers, and as you know, we have an extremely strong email program. We deliver millions of emails through Nupanda. We are now allowing and encouraging all of our users to begin to also establish a mobile alert subscription from each contact. And that means when you're signing up from one of our widgets on your website, or when you're promoting your service, or when you're encouraging folks to join your mailing list, wherever that may be, even on the pad of paper on your counter at the store, we want to make sure that you're not only just getting name and email, but also now mobile number. Yeah, because it's big and it's continuing to grow. For those of you, by the way, on our international audience, I have some exciting news. Don't have a lot of time to go into detail on it, but I will tell you for those questions coming in that we are now supporting direct phone numbers in multiple countries, and we'll be rolling those out. And for our friends just a little north in Canada, we do have a number already set up and working and in testing. So if you're in Canada, then be sure to let us know. And again, use that question answer option if you're on live. So first of all, I want to talk about these mobile listings. It's an item you'd like to market, a campaign you'd like to share, and that means that it can be a specific product or service. That could be the new York-style pizza your shop has just introduced. It could be the house that you've just put on the market. It could be the new type of homeowner policy that you offer in the insurance industry. It could even be the car on the lot for those of you who are joining us in our new auto edition of Nupanda. The bottom line is we provide these options so that you can market a product or even market yourself and allow a keyword to even be your name or your business's name just to get a basic overview. Well, I'm calling it, for lack of a better term, I think we're going to roll it out as an electronic business card. Just for you, just about you, with your logo or with your personal professional photo. And the sky's the limit. There are lots of opportunities here. I just want to show you. You've probably seen these everywhere you go. I mean, you may be more aware than others or not, but I will tell you this. Everywhere we look now, marketers are realizing the value of text messaging as an easy way to capture an audience's attention and deliver immediate information. Now, the reasons that happen, and when we have a webinar that's more dedicated to the statistics, I'll share with you that the open rate of text messages is over 95%. And for those of you who've used email with us, you know that's a significantly higher number of open rates. Why? Because we're on our phone. So here at Kindred, right, and it's with us at all times, and we're even more so now using texting, even instead of calling like my teenage daughter who will never do so, or early 20s daughter. Anyway, so here's an example of Kindred using a texting Kindred to 30364. It's a health related agency. Joe's is a pizza organization, so the message, wherever it might be shared, is text Joe's to 313-1311. Well, that's a lot harder than our short code, but anyway, I found this example. You're now a preferred text member, so also special offers are being added. The texting of Joe's leads to Joe's Pizza and a 20% off next order offer. Here's a great one. I love this because we have a lot of folks getting signage from us, whether it's a window cling or a decal or something in the window that is a 24-hour, 7-day-a-week message to potential customers who might have walked up to your door and it's 3 in the morning. Well, maybe not, but it's 9:30 at night and the kitchen's closed, etc. It could even be for, of course, lots of our folks have in the real estate edition our yard signs and riders, and those promote the concept of joining or getting information. In this case, it's text to the word next to 683398. Here's another one from a radio station to join a club. So you can do this type of approach as well and have folks join you in your text alert club. Now, those were all text message generated inquiries, and that's something that our mobile tools offers, and we also offer now a QR code. And by the way, just to tell you in advance, the way we do this is for one listing, we're gonna give you everything we have. Every way will be included that will help you to promote in an appropriate way. So here's eBay promoting a QR code that someone will scan and get then information delivered to their phone. Here's one in Japan, actually, that's promoting, and it's right on a big billboard on a building. Don't worry, this is in a residential, it's in a big commerce district, but there are very few cars, and if there are, they move very slowly. So it's not as much a danger as you might think. And here's a good old park bench or a bus station bench, which I love seeing, with a QR code as well, tying to a REMAX agent. The point with QR codes is, and any thoughts you have on this, please share them with us. They're a wonderful enticement for a home for sale, for a product, for a table tent on the table at a restaurant. They're great for those consumers who understand the technology and have downloaded a QR code reader. Now, I've done it, but I got to tell you, I'm not as frequently snapping or trying to get the little box around the QR code to pull up information as I am texting. So I'm telling you, we're giving these features, and QR codes are easy for all of us to produce, of course. But the point is, I believe that we need to have multiple ways to communicate and share the details of our products. So I want to cover what those are, the part of what's included in our mobile message service. So to do that, I'm going to jump, actually I started that, hang on just a second. We're going to first offer you a voice hotline. Now, what that means is someone can pick up a phone, and could be their mobile phone, chances are it will be, and they can dial a good old-fashioned phone number, like a hotline. And we have toll-free versions, we have some local versions, so you can use a local number, but we'll show you how you can pick a number or even just dial to a 800 number, toll-free number. And you'll punch in a code, and you'll then hear details of that product or that listing. And then from the message, you can directly connect to the store, to the real estate agent, to the radio station, or you can press another button to get a text message sent to the phone you're calling from. So that's a pretty exciting way. Voice is a part of our service. Texting is as well. So you'll text a code, a keyword. And it might be the same numeric code, that always works, by the way, that you can use on the voice hotline. But you could also text 123-MAIN and have a text message immediately delivered back to you about this property on Grandview Boulevard. It'll always show your name or business name, your phone number, which is available as a quick link then. And you can get pics and info and more updates at this short URL that's custom to every message we send, or even reply to this text with your email address. And that captures an email address that we then register in your new Panda contact list, of course. Now, when you click the link in the text message, if you have mobile website browsing capabilities. Now, we talked about text messaging. Over 95% is not only the open rate of those, but it's also over the 90s of phones that now have text messaging and that support text messaging. So it's a big audience. But if you don't have mobile browsing, right, accessing the web, it's okay. You can simply go back to this version where you call the number or you text the number and you get the text info and you reply with your email and you'll get an email with full pictures and info and details. If you do have mobile web browsing, you'll get a beautiful photo, details of the property or the product or whatever you're promoting, your own personal business card. And this scrolls down to even include a library of additional photos. Not only that, I mentioned the email from either the text message or the property page or the detail page. There's a link at the bottom allowing you to provide your email in both cases, which delivers a full, feature-rich, photo-rich email to the inbox. And we've captured that consumer's email address now, and now we can send them additional emails. I mentioned a QR code. All of these are included in what's called a mobile listing. So the QR code goes to the detail page on the phone. We have signage, both for everything from tabletop tents for restaurants to yard signs for real estate companies to be able to call a phone number and enter a code. We have signs that allow you to text a code or a keyword to 22033, a short code. We even have printable flyers that are included in this and that integrate our QR codes. All of that's part of what we offer in our service. Here's a preview now of a brand new example of our table tent. I've been mentioning that this could be next to a cash register. This could be right on a table. This could be right in the window of even a house for sale. And of course, we have different riders and such to support that. But the idea is we encourage folks to get info by text, pics, and an e-brochure by texting a keyword, in this case, pizza, to 22033. By the way, we'll test this a little bit later, but for those of you who are already getting on your mobile phones while we're talking, I think we have one that's already set up for pizza. We'll test that. And then, of course, coffee or any other service or product. Now, re-emphasize one thing, then we'll jump online and look at a couple of things on the web in our app. But first of all, the result of our message is to drive consumers to a full property detail and to have captured their email. And as I mentioned, that's done by voice. That's done by a QR code. That's done by texting. A text goes out to specifically text 123 Main. The consumer then immediately receives that response and can immediately click and link to that property. Now, best of all, as every single one of these activities occur, you, the business owner, agent, specialist, you can receive an instant text alert to you and or an email sent to you. Here's what they say. So this is a new Panda mobile listing activity. It's occurred at 4:59. Its source was a direct text. By the way, this would actually tell you if it was a QR code or if it was a voice call. The phone number of that caller in voice cases or that texter, if it was a direct text message, is this. So we have the caller ID sent to you and the name from caller ID, if it's a phone call, and the listing or the request that they had made, in this case on Rudy Lane. Here's the same concept, but in an email, I'm going to show you how you have the options to set up both the option to receive every text message for every time an activity occurs or to receive an email. Now, let me tell you that we've found a lot of exposure from this program, especially with some of our original testers and our corporate enterprise clients that use this for multiple products. So what I will say is when a user has the ability to receive these text alerts or emails, there are two ways you could respond to this. Number one, it's great information and it shows you that activity is happening. Number two, you could call that number carefully and position your message carefully. If this were, say, a window QR code on an automobile, and I was the dealer for that shop or that car lot. I might call that consumer back, and if I were going to, I would be careful to say something like, "Hi, this is Bob from Bob's Auto Lot, and I just saw a report that you checked out our new E-Class Mercedes-Benz. Let's live. Let's think high, right? And then I'll say, I just wanted to confirm that you got all the information you need and you don't have any further questions, right? So something that's a softer, a gentler approach to that. Now, here's what I've found, though, in the last year, some amazing feedback from our new Panda customers, our users, who have found that what they do instead is they receive this text message on their phone, mobile phone, they click the link, and they send a text message back. So the consumer just got a text with the details. Maybe they've then checked out the photos online, etc. But you're able to then say, hey, it's Bob. I wanted to call about your request on our new product and see if there was other info you needed, question mark. I don't know if I just exceeded 140, 160 characters, but you can send those direct texts back, and it's an amazing way to generate response. And I will tell you this, not exactly scientifically yet, but when I get shows of hands from the room, I definitely am seeing that those who text back one of the consumers who responds and requests information, they see a dramatically higher favorability, response rate, meaning instead of getting a ring, no answer, or never a callback, they're seeing that the folks actually do text them right back. So they appreciate that. It leaves them a little more anonymity, and it seems to be a real good. So I'd love to hear your feedback as you're testing those out. Let's do this. I'm going to jump over to first show you this concept of listings and how you'll create one. Now, first, let me tell you this. We are right now, I'm going to let you know, for those of you who are on the live call, many of you have been working with us in a beta phase for some of these listing or mobile tools. And if you would like, we'd like to offer you a couple more beta spots or opportunities as we're rolling this out. The links are not live in everyone's account yet, so just know that if you're not seeing it right away, we'll send you notice when it's available to everyone. And if you'd like to participate with us in a little more testing over the next week or so, be sure to send us a notice at help@newpanda.com. Now, I'm in a page that you all will see soon to select a listing, one of the listings that I've chosen. I can see the name of my the piece that I am marketing, whatever type of product that is. The source will show me the details of where how that came to me. The voice ID will illustrate the code that could be punched in on a phone hotline. And the keyword in this case is to text the word home or to text the word pizza to 22033. And these are all open. Now, what I want to do next is I want to set up a new one. So a real estate listing is going to have all those details for a property. And if you're in any other category, you're going to see that you can promote a car or a rental or a job or stuff or anything, even your own personal business card. And to do that, you basically can, you have the option of entering a price and an alternate ID for that property if you're trying to match this up to something. The most important thing that you want to share is join, and this is the headline, all right, I'm going to put it in all caps, join our pizza club, all right, and I'm going to put a subheadline of receive special, remember, I can't type very well, offers and info from Bob's Pizza. All right, and I'm then going to put an even longer description, which means you can type a whole lot more detail, that whatever you'd like in this. And then you can either link to the page that we give you, or you can put in your own URL, meaning when a consumer texts the code or the keyword or calls, they'll be given this specific URL to go to, short URL, because we're going to track them for you. But you have the ability to send that to your own detail page, virtual tour, you name it, wherever you'd like that link to go. You can specify that in this URL section. Now, the next piece is to add photos. All right, so I'm going to put a photo name here, and that, whoops, I think I already click to choose file. So I'm going to just put in here, I'm trying to make sure it's not too large of one. Ooh, I'll share one of our barber's sign up form with you. How's that? And I'm going to put, just to show you the concept, that this is Woody's photo one. And I'm going to then click the plus button, and you're going to see, in this case I did not put a description for this particular photo that I chose, but I'm going to be able to then add, if I want, a description to that, and that can be with as much detail as you want. But here is the, this is literally a barbershop that we worked with, where you can text Woody to 22033, right? And then I can add additional photos, so this photos, right, you'll want to choose good relevant names for these. But if I want, then I can also choose janesrealty.png, and I can continue now to add additional right options and photos, as many as I'd like. I can always check my spelling. And finally, I can save that listing. Now what the key is that you'll see that we have added a listing, and now the next steps are a voice and a text ID. Those are all the pages that are going to be available to you, those working with us in this last final testing period, and then of course all of you when we launch this. It's scheduled target date for this, by the way, is the very beginning of April, potentially sooner for many of you, so keep an eye out for those details. Now, I want to jump back to that settings option that I was mentioning. Here are the settings details for the pages that you can go to, and they include the ability to receive instant email alerts. So you'll receive an email every time a contact requests one of your mobile hotline or your mobile listing codes. An instant text message can also be sent to you every time. You'll provide your phone number for the mobile phone, right, that we'll be sending to. And then you can even pick from other phone numbers if you want, for which will be displayed in the text messages received by consumers, meaning it could be the mobile number you've already provided us, it could be your main number at your location, store, mobile phone, etc. Then you have the option to also receive a daily email summary if you'd like. Just you might choose that instead of the instant alerts. You can store those hotline calls or those text messages as contacts, which by default, again, we're going to send you an instant alert notification, and then we're also going to store and allow you to have those be right in with a task, even, so you can have a task that is put into your to-do list in New Panda. All those are options if you're using our CRM product. And then finally, you can also decide if you want to be alerted on duplicate inquiries, which are sort of fun, actually. Sometimes they're obnoxious, but we'll find that a consumer will see a property or see an auto or see a sign on a billboard, and they'll text to get information, and they'll get it on their phone. And interestingly, we'll see another one come from that same number, meaning they'll do it again, maybe when they are with their spouse or a decision maker, or they're revisiting that those options again. So it's interesting. But you can decide if you want to receive those duplicates or not. All right, those are the basic settings and setup of sending specifically mobile listings. There's a lot more information, as I mentioned. If you go to newpanda.com, check the appropriate business type you're in, and then click the mobile ads option, you'll see that our pricing is set at $25 per ad. Now, if you're with one of our global brokerage firms who provide this tool, then and or one of our enterprise clients, you may not have a charge for these. But if you do, the pricing is $25 for each of those products or listings that you add, or you have a $35 per month unlimited option, which is a pretty good deal if you plan on setting up multiple unique QR codes / keywords / phone IDs. There's some video information here, an encouragement to try it yourself by sending a text with the message. So you're going to send the message 12345 to the short code 22033. It's sort of like American Idol, you know, in a way. But the good news is this is available on all carriers, all major carriers in the U.S. As I mentioned, we'll have specific phone numbers and an increasing number of them internationally as we're growing our global audience. And you'll also be able to view the details of, again, all the things that you get as part of that one fee of $25 or one of your 35 unlimiteds a month, and all the things you can market and the ability for you to get started. When you do, that'll take you specifically to the shopping cart, and you can add mobile ads. buy a quantity or even choose the unlimited option to get multiple of them. So that's a brief overview on the mobile listing side. What I'd also like to just show you super quick is the concept of mobile alerts, or the ability to sign up a mobile subscriber base that I mentioned earlier. The beauty there is that group text messages allow you to basically add and specify in your contacts someone who will be a mobile subscriber in addition or instead of an email subscriber. And then once you've got your mobile subscribers, you can create custom text messages. It's just like you create an email message, you know, when you're sending out an email from our templates, etc., or a social post through NewPanda. You can also create a mobile message linking back to even that property or that specific item that you promoted. And we track it all with these short URLs, all right, that are put into every mobile message. So if I go to NewPanda, I click Send Your Messages, and I create a new message, and let's say I want to make that one specifically a mobile listing. I might even put then in that mobile test, and I want to send an alert to my mobile subscribers. What I'll do is I'll jump ahead here to mobile messages, and I don't have the product. Can I borrow someone's credit card, by the way? But here's the ability for you to set up your message, and actually this is how you can get started by clicking here and signing up for the program, which you can do, by the way, now. We will prorate or extend your expiration out from whenever that feature. It could be today that you can set up the codes with you, and we'll talk to you about that. But if it's a week from now, we'll make sure we extend out that time frame for you. All right. One last thing, and that is that under Manage Your Contacts, there is now the ability for you to specifically do some filtering and even invite some folks based on their mobile activity. So when I go to Manage My Contacts and I click Filter Contacts, see now how I have a checkbox for mobile callers. Those are those who have been added to my list because they called or texted. I also have an option here for mobile subscribers. So these are those who are already have a positive confirmation. There's also mobile unconfirmed, meaning they've not responded to our request to become a mobile subscriber of ours. And there are also mobile requests. These are contacts who we've sent a request to. Now, we won't have always sent a request to every individual, true? So, and we need to do that before we can just blanket import or call everyone a mobile subscriber. So what I want to show you is I clicked on a contact. There's a subscription info section. There's the email opt-out info, right? But there's also the text messaging status. And this person is not confirmed. And if I want to send them a confirmation request, this will send a text message to Michael Smith to his mobile phone, and that text message will ask him if he'd like to join your mobile mailing list. Does that make sense? So he becomes a mobile subscriber. Once you get in here and you start to even use yourself as a test contact, put in your mobile number, try that, you'll get the text, you'll see how it works. That's all live and ready and working, and so please begin to think about all of these things mobile. And thanks for joining us for this mobile tools overview.